Good afternoon, students. Already I completed 100% syllabus for wireless mobile communication subject. But once again, I am sharing here one lecture on some few points, which is again repeating one. I am repeating these particular points. In briefly, I will repeat all these particular points and I will discuss the entire whole syllabus once again so that you will get some sort of the help while studying the for the examination or while studying the this particular subject during the for that particular preparation of the examination. Okay, from this wireless mobile communication subject, I'm going to discuss the points from the unit 6, that means last unit, as the mobile network and transport layer. From that unit, I'm considering 2-3 points as the first one is the fast retransmit. Okay, it's here, fast retransmit. Oblique fast recovery, that means fast retransmit and fast recovery. So whenever the any device which is entering in the foreign region, that means any device, that means mobile device, whenever it is leaving its home region and is entering in the other region, at that time some sort of the data packet it is getting receiving in a slower manner. Okay, it is getting slower manner. At that time, due to the entering in the foreign region, might be that TCP layer gets that it gets that particular thing that it is due to the some sort of the congestion this happening. Which one? The getting the information, getting the packets. It is maybe happened due to the congestion. But at this situation, the MAC layer understand that it is not the congestion. It is due to the, you can see that whenever the one device it is coming from one its home network to the other network, at that time it happens like that. MAC layer it understand, but the TCP layer it understand that it is happening due to the congestion of the packets, but it is not the case. At that time corresponding node it is not having any problem, but it is continuously transmitting one. So in this situation, what the layer it is doing one, as per the consideration of the idea from by the CACRIS, whatever the that particular data it is getting, that means it is, you can see that getting slower one, at that time faster rate, that means it is forced to transfer the data in a faster way by using this particular idea from the CACRIS in 1995. So it is said that it is artificially transported that data in a faster way when that particular device it is considered in the other region. That is nothing but your retransmission or fast transmission of that particular data. So, and the as per the corresponding node it is continuously transmitting, it is not having any problem. The that particular the device which is entering in the foreign region, whenever it is getting this particular slow start, or the data it is made get be you can say that very loss of that data may be happen, but it is not due to the congestion. It is a correct thing by the MAC layer. So slow, it is getting slower one, or might be sometimes that data may be corrupted. So artificially data can be again retransmitted or transmitted in a faster way, so that whatever the data it is getting corrupted or lost one, it is again recovered one. That is concept, it is nothing but it is the fast retransmission and fast recovery. Here whatever the due to the slow start, due to the entering in this particular foreign region, at that time some data it get lost one, so that data it is get recovered one. It is get recovered one in the form of retransmission of data in a faster way. That concept is nothing but your fast recovery or faster transmission. only this having the advantage that it is a it is having the simplicity, it is the main advantages. And disadvantage is that this concept, it is not isolation, it is doing the in between the cap packets. That means isolation problem which is happening due to this particular, or it is not that much sufficient to isolate these packets. This is the disadvantage of this particular approach. But whenever the mobile host it is entering in any region, at that time whatever the due to the slow transmission or that particular loss of the data, it can be, you can see that, recovered. This is the one point. Now next point is the transmission and timeout. Transmission and timeout. Time out, that is called as also freezing. So this type of a concept, it is happened due to the short interrupts. This particular transmission and timeout freezing. This type of a concept, I am not saying it is not the feasible to say that it is occurring. This concept it is used whenever the data it is lost due to the small interrupt or short interruption which is happen in between the transmitter and the receiver or that particular mobile devices which is used by that particular you can say that user. For example, if suppose one of the user, he is traveling by car and he is entered in a tunnel, and you already know that whenever you are entering in the tunnels, might be sometimes you are not getting the proper signal. It is a small example. So at that time what happened, whenever you are coming out that particular from the tunnel, then only you will get the good signal. So due to this situation, what happens, the transmission of a data, even though corresponding node it is transmitting data, but at the receiver side the mobile device it is not getting, it is interrupted one, and that data it is lost one. So here TCP it is understand that okay, it is due to the congestion and it is not, that means we are that means that data it is not get received. But again that MAC layer it understand that this is not the congestion, this is due to the any other reason. That thing it is understand by the MAC layer, and at that situation what the MAC layer it is done, it gives the instruction to the TCP to hold some sort of the time period to receive that information. This concept is called as the freezing. So that TCP layer what it is doing, it is waiting for some sort of the duration, and whenever that particular mobile host it is coming out of that particular tunnel, at that time whenever the signal get it one, that particular TCP layer it comes out from the freeze and it receives the information. That is called as the transmission of that particular data after some sort of the timeout duration, after some of the time of duration. Got this thing? What exactly the transmission and timeout freezing during entering in the tunnel? The MAC layer it understand that this is not due to the congestion, and to recover from that particular congestion, it instructs the TCP layer wait for some sort of the, that means hold that particular situation as it is, and whenever that particular mobile device it comes from the outside the tunnel, at that time whenever the signal it gets received one, the TCP layer automatically it gets the signal or information or packets. So that particular TCP layer then comes from the freeze concept and it continues that particular information. This is the, you can see that concept behind this particular transmission and timeout. So it is having that particular advantage that it resumes the TCP to connect for that particular connection even after the longer interruption. This is the main advantages. And disadvantage is that some software it is not that much supporting on that particular devices, and due to that might be it will not work properly. That is the, you can see that transmission timeout freezing. Okay, now next point is the selective retransmission. retransmission. Now, in this situation, now this is the third point from this particular your mobile network and transport layer point. Okay, selective retransmission. It is also already we discussed these things, but briefly I am going to here discussing these points. Here, due to any cause, any reason, even though the corresponding node it is sending the information packets in the network, but that particular mobile device, it is due to some sort of the interruption, it is not getting that particular sequence of packets properly. It is not getting one, some sort of the packet may get lost one, or that particular packet it is getting some sort of the loss of the information. At that time, what the TCP it is doing, it is finding out which packet it is having problematical, that information it is sharing that particular in the network, and once again it is saying that transmit only that particular lost packet. So previously what happens, the packet, see, you are sending the information in a packet wise, in a sequential manner or whatever, but at the receiver end, whatever the that particular packet it is get received on, suppose any packet, say one fourth packet it is having the problem, it is not received properly one, then in this case what happens, fourth onward again all the packets are get retransmitted one. But in this selective retransmission concept, what we are doing here, only that packet which is having problematical, that is only retransmitted. That's why it is called as a selective retransmission. That is only get transmitted. Advantage is that unnecessarily use of the bandwidth for that entire message after the lost packets, it is not required one. Only that much packet it is get transmitted. Okay, this is the, you can see that advantages, and minor it is having the some sort of the software issue at the receiver side. Because of the necessity of that particular buffers and all that thing, it is a minor disadvantage, but main advantage it is that it is minimizing the, you can see that whatever the bandwidth side it is required for the sending the entire retransmitting the lost onwards packets data, it is not there, only selective data it is transmitting. So time and this particular bandwidth it is saved on. This is the, you can see that this selective retransmission. Now next point is the transaction oriented TCP. Okay, that is also we discussed one, how the TCP it is support for that particular sending and receiving the data, we will discuss here. See, transaction oriented TCP, suppose there is a one client is there. See here, I am just drawing this particular thing. One client is there and one server is there. Then this particular server, it is get one information from the client as the TCP sync. Then it is giving the TCP sync acknowledgement, right? And exactly it is again asking for the TCP acknowledgement, and then this is called as the connection setup. This is called as the how the connection it is set up one, and after that then this particular client, whatever they it want to access that particular thing, it is giving the request. Okay, and according to that request, this is HTTP, it is getting the response, right? It is getting the response. So that here in this case, you are, what you are doing, data transmission you are doing, right? Now and depends on how that particular connection it is happening, you are doing the that particular less than suppose 50 second no data it is transmitted, then connection it is get released, connection release, right? Now see here what the thing it is happening. So in this case, one client is there, one server is there. Then what the client it is doing, whenever he want to communicate with that particular server, at that time he gives the request to this particular server. That is the, it is giving the request for the connection with that particular server in the form of a TCP request. It is called as a TCP synchronization. At that case, when the server it gets that particular request and it is working on that particular thing, then it forwards the TCP with the acknowledgement of that particular synchronization. Right? Once the TCP it is forwarded to this particular client from the server, and that particular synchronization acknowledgement which is received to this client, then client realizes that now I can establish the connection with the this particular server, because server it is responding with this that particular TCP connection. So it is again giving the that particular acknowledgement to the server as the TCP received that particular TCP, like that acknowledgement. Once this particular handshaking it is done one, then this particular concept it is called as the connection setup in between the client and the server. Right? That means now the connection it is established with the server by the client. Now the purpose of the client to connect that particular server is that to access something, that may be any kind of, here for example it is considered as the HTTP, hypertext transfer protocol, it is used one. That means that client want to access the some sort of the web page, right? Then he is giving the request here through this particular link. Here it is giving that particular request as the HTTP request to the server. Once that particular server gets such a kind of a request, then it will work on that particular request, and for that request it gives the response. Then the, as per the TCP connection and that particular request, HTTP request, then the client and server, they are now, after the connection setup, they are now exchanging the information, that is the data transmission it is happening in between them. Right? Got the thing? That means client it is accessing the data from the server, that it is established in between that particular server and that particular client. If suppose client it is not doing anything after some transmission and all that thing, that means might be he finished that particular work. So server waits for some sort of the duration, and if suppose that duration exceeds greater than 15 seconds, then automatically that connection get released one. Automatically that connection gets released one, because server want to share this particular, if anyone asked for that particular connection. Getting the thing? So this kind of a connection, it is called as a TCP oriented, that means transaction oriented TCP, not TCP. Transaction oriented TCP, this type of a connection, where the first TCP request it is given by the client, then as per the synchronization by the client to with the server it is giving releasing the TCP, that means accepting his request and giving the TCP access to the client, then client it is accessing that particular, that means giving the acknowledgement for that particular TCP, and once this particular transaction it is happen, it is called as a connection setup. Once the connection setup it is happen, then the for that particular application, client it is giving the request, and that particular data transmission it is happen with the use of that particular TCP in between the server and client. This is the your transaction oriented TCP. Got this thing? This is the one point. Now next point is the our the this particular TCP over 2.5G and 3G. Normally in wireless network, before this particular 2G, 2.5G and 3G, whatever the that particular technology it is implemented one, it is either the second generation or first generation. First generation it is working on the analog concept, second generation it is started with the digital concept, but the rate of the data transmission is some sort of the not that much one, higher one. So here TCP it is considered on the as consideration of the as per the today's technology for transmission of that particular data with having the some sort of the standards, wireless standards, as GSM, GPRS, UTMS or that particular CDMA 2000. Like that this particular technology it is considered, and today's and tomorrow's that particular wireless concept it is implemented by considering this particular thing, which is improving, you can see that, which is improving the rate of transmission of that particular data signal. And by considering that, some sort of the, you can see that characteristic it is considered for this particular 2.5 and 3G wireless network by considering that this particular TCP. And first that particular characteristics is the data rate. Okay, data rate it is increased having the upload and download having for this particular 2.5 and 3G. I am giving the common one, that means higher rate here only. Lower is also there, that means considering the 2.5 and then considering the 3.5, but I am commonly saying that particular thing. That means from 10 to, or you can say that 64 kbps for uplink and 115 to 384 kbps for downlink, right? That means by using this particular 3G concept, you can get this much download and upload the rate. That is the data rate, increase the data rate. Second one is the, you can see that latency, right? In wireless system, you can see that elaborate algorithm for the error correction and protection concept that is considered under this particular latency. That means forward error correction, reverse error correction, for that purpose you have to use some sort of the checksum. These concepts are considered in this particular latency point. Jitter, third one is the jitter. Jitter, whenever the such a latency it is occurring, that means you can see that due to that error correction, that data loss and all that thing, at that time forward error correction and this some protection concept checksums are considered, which are happening. That means it is latency characteristics when it is implemented, at that time this jitter concept it is implemented, so that whatever the delay in the that particular data transmit, which is called as the delay spikes, it can be solved one in radio transmission. It can be solved, and for that purpose jitter concept it is considered, so that this particular problem it can be removed. And third last one is the packet loss. That packet loss it is happen. See, these are the main three four characteristics. So packet loss it is considered during the hardware issue or due to the, you can some sort of the corruption of that particular data. Okay, so by considering the 2.5 and 3G, this particular packet loss it can be minimized by, because you are increasing the some sort of the data rate, as well as the, you are having some sort of the correction error correction concept, that means checksum and all that thing you are implemented on, so that you can recover that particular information at that particular layers. This is the, you can see that characteristic. And for this particular characteristics, this particular 2.5 and 3G, it using some sort of the, you can see that parameter, right? It using the parameters, and these parameters are, first one is the large window size, then second one is the limited transmission, that concept you are considering here, and fourth one is the large maximum transfer unit concept. And then selective acknowledgement, these parameters are considered. Explicit conjunction notification notification. Notification. Then you can say that timestamps, and last one is no header. No header compression. So by using this parameter, you can increase the rate of transmission of that particular. You can increase the data rate transmission of that particular information in the network. So every parameter, it works for that particular thing by considering the large window size for the packet sending, like that selective acknowledgement, no header compression, it is not necessary. Some that thing it is considered one. And limited transmit, that means for that particular duration, what, how much exactly you can transmit, like that considering you can transmit the information in the network. And by considering these parameters, you can increase, that means by using the these concepts are utilized in this particular 2.5 and 3G concept, and it will increase the rate of data transmission in the network, so that data can be transmitted having the minimizing the errors. I am not saying that 100% that error it is removed one, but because in wireless network there are interruption, it is happening due to so many clauses. So I am not saying that, but it is these parameters which will help to the improve this particular thing. Okay, so these are the some sort of the points which is considered under this particular TCP over 2.5G and 3G wireless network. By considering this point, I said that already I have finished the 100% syllabus before our that particular closing. That means due to that particular Corona, we are not attending that means college. So before that, I already finished the 100% syllabus. But I am here once again. This repeated these things, and by considering this point of view, I will just briefly share the from unit 1 onwards, just I will explain the things. So mobile radio propagation, in that you have to consider the large scale path loss. From that it is important the things are the free space propagation model, related power that particular to the electrical field, then reflection, diffraction, refraction, scattering, these things are important one. Then two-ray model, it is also important point from this particular thing. Sometimes outdoor propagation, indoor propagation, on that question may be there, so you study in that manner. Then signal penetration into the buildings, ray tracing, and site specific modeling, it is on that particular. You can say that there may be question one there. So from this particular unit, the importance are you have to concentrate on that particular free space propagation, related power, three that particular propagation mechanism, then two ray modeling, then the practical link budget using path loss. Then you have to again concentrate on that outdoor indoor propagation, signal penetration into the building. These points you have to consider one, which is considered for this particular first unit. Second unit, it is again same top, that means title is there, mobile radio propagation, but it is again considered for the small scale propagation and feeding, multipath feeding. So in this also you have to concentrate on the small scale propagation concept, a multipath concept, impulse response modeling, then small scale multipath measurement, parameters of mobile multipath channels, types of the small scale feeding, Rayleigh and Racine distribution, 100% question may be there from these two, and then statistical model for the multipath channel. So impulse response, they will ask the question. Then parameters of mobile multipath channel, 100% they will ask the question. And types of the feeding and multipath measurement, on that also they will ask the question. So be careful on these particular topics. Then wireless network and introduction to the wireless network. In that you will get the, that means difference between wireless and fixed telephone network, you have to consider that. Then the development of a wireless network, fixed network, transmission hierarchy, traffic routing, wireless data services. Important is the common signaling, common channel signaling. It is important one. ISDN is also important one. SS7 is also important one. From these three, at least two, they will ask 100% question. So remember that particular point. Okay. So be care about this. Students, I appeal you people that don't consider any point for the option. Don't consider any point. You have to study all these points. These three units you will get from the Rapoport book. These three units you will get from the Rapoport book. No problem, no doubt. Okay. Now, next unit is the fourth unit. Introduction to mobile communication and multipath technique. From that mobile and personal communication, you have to discuss, that means you have to study on that particular what exactly mobile and personal communication is there, which are the mobile and wireless devices are there, you have to share that thing. Then specified packet and mobile radio network, circuit switch data services and cellular network, packet switch services and cellular network. These whatever the points are there, it is, I am having that particular notes with me. I already many times I said that you can take, collect from that particular notes from me. I will try to share this one by considering the PDF and all other, might be in other way. I will try to share with you people. But remember these things, that these points you will get from that particular notes only. In that again you have to study how the CDPD concept is there, what is the that particular SMS technique is there, what the exact packet switching is there, circuit switching is there. That thing you will get from this particular thing, and 100% two or three questions it is considered from these points, 100%. Now multiple access technique you will get this particular point from Rapoport also. So you know that particular term, FDMA, TDMA, all these things, you know that thing, you can study from that particular thing. Now next unit is the wireless LAN. In this, again, introduction to the wireless LAN, then infrared radio transmission, infrastructure and ad hoc network. In this, you have to discuss what exactly the infrared wireless network, what exactly the radio transmission wireless network, and apart from this, what exactly the infrastructure and ad hoc network, you have to explain, because this point it is getting confusion one. So remember that infrared and radio transmission, these are two different points. Then infrastructure and ad hoc network is also, these two are different points, right? You consider this particular, you understand this particular thing. And then detailed study of this particular IEEE 802.11 standard, which is specifically considered for the wireless network, that you have to understand one. And the, it is having up to N, A, B, C, D to the N, up to N you are having that particular, that it is having that particular types. It is starting from physical layer, MAC layer, and then HyperLAN 1, HyperLAN 2, that concept it is considered one. Then WATM and Bluetooth concept it is considered one. 100% it is having 2-3 questions, 100%. So from this IEEE 802.11 Bluetooth, wireless, ATM and all that thing. And one question from the particular infrared radio transmission infrastructure and that particular ad hoc network, they will ask for. So that, and in HyperLAN 2 you have to consider the modes, HyperLAN 2, that network modes you have to consider one. It is important, it will be asked one. Okay, that is the thing. Now last is the last unit is the mobile network and transport layer. Just I explained few last few points. In that, what exactly the mobile IP, what the DHCP concept is there, then mobile and ad hoc network, already we discussed that ad hoc network and infrastructure network in wireless, it is related to that, but it is considered for the mobile, so remember that thing. Bluetooth already we discussed, that is again comes once again. Wi-Fi network, that is also considered one. Then traditional TCP. See, traditional TCP, indirect TCP, snooping TCP, mobile TCP, from that, and transaction oriented TCP. From that, whatever the points are there, definitely two or three points they will ask. Definitely they will ask at least 2 points in exam. So be care about this thing. Then fast and selective retransmission and recovery of that particular information, transaction oriented information, just I shared, and TCP over 2.5 and 3G wireless network. This is the things. So once again I am saying that every unit, it is related to each other. First two units are, no doubt, it is a large scale and small scale, but some points are again related to each other. Then wireless network, what exactly wireless network? Onwards that, whatever the fourth unit, fifth unit, sixth, they are related to each other. No doubt the concept, it is different, but some sort of the things are considered in that. So remember that you have to study in a proper way. You have to concentrate on each and every point. Don't keep any option for that particular points. 100% every question, it is important to you people. By considering this, you have to write the proper answer whenever you are attempting that particular in exam. So be care about it. I want to say that unit number 5th and 6th, it is 100% you will get from the John Schiller book. 100% you will get all the information, no doubt. Only thing is that John Schiller and Rappaport, it is a huge information. You just understand and you just read properly, so you will get the idea. This subject you will get score. You can get score, but you have to carefully study one. Okay, so good luck. And I will try to share the unit number 4's that particular notes with you people. I already shared that multiple access technique you may get from Rappaport as well as this particular John Schiller. You go for Rappaport. It is in detail in the Rappaport. Okay, thank you guys and good luck.